Hey guys, Eric here with Motivated by the Mission, and today I'm going to show you a quadrant that I made to help to gauge where you're at each day and what sort of attitude and energy that you're bringing. A lot of us, most people who subscribe to this channel and who are interested in the Motivated by the Mission message, we want to be difference makers. We want to make a contribution to our society in a positive way. We want to show up each day with the energy necessary to make that level of contribution that we hope to make. And we want to make sure that we have a good enough attitude where we feel good about what we're doing each day, because we deserve that. And this quadrant, it's a way for us to assess, a way for us to gauge where we fall. And I want you to make sure, if you're not in an area that you want to be in, don't judge yourself, because each day we're going to be a little bit different. But with this assessment tool, we're able to be aware quickly and then make the necessary changes to get where we want to be, which is ultimately high energy, good attitude, high energy. Okay? So let's start in the lower areas. So all of us have had the days where we show up and we don't have the best attitude in the world, right? We don't have the best attitude, and quite frankly, our energy levels are low, and I've dealt with this, and I think most of the viewers probably have too. When you're showing up like that, what you are, and what I was, it's funny to say, I was a dud. When I was showing up and my energy levels were low, and I was complaining about everything going on in the world, the traffic, I get to work, I'm complaining about this. It was a dud, and it was impacting how I felt about myself. Most importantly, it was impacting my mission, right? I wasn't able to contribute because of the level that I was at. So low attitude, low energy, we're duds. We don't want to be duds, okay? So if we are, I'll show you some tips at the end how to get out of that category. All right, second thing, when your energy's high, right? So you show up, you have a ton of energy, but your attitude's crap, your attitude's low. And we know people like this. These are the people who are at the water cooler, and they're influencers, they have plenty of energy, but they're complaining about everything under the sun within the company or within the community, or why isn't this person doing enough? And quite frankly, that can be a distraction, So we want to make sure that inadvertently we're not being distractions, or if we notice, people on our team, members, of our club, or people who even have the same objective, we can gently point out to them, or more effectively, we could just consistently embody our best selves and say, look, I've been where you're at. I recognize, you're not happy with some things, but maybe if you focus on the right things, which we'll get into later, you could utilize that energy in a more positive manner, and make a difference rather than complain about what's not going right. So that's just something to think about. High energy, bad attitude, we're distractions. Okay, so this one's a little deceiving. So, you show up, you have a great attitude, you show up consistently, but you just don't have the energy. You're just kind of lethargic, but you're there, you're consistent, you're consistently showing up, let's say, to the community meetings at night to help, help try to solve an issue locally. Or even work, I keep coming back to the work example, but all of us have to go to work each day. Maybe you're showing up and you're there, you're on time, you're doing just enough, you're dedicated, right? So dedicated is deceiving, because in society, they'll champion that. They'll say, yeah, dedicated, great, you're dedicated. But that's not what we're here to do. We're on this earth only one time. We have one shot at this life. Let's make sure that we're taking care of ourselves so that our energy matches our attitude, and then what we are, and this is where all of us need to be striving to be, we're difference makers. That's what we want to be. We want to make a difference in our world. We want to make a difference with our families. We want to make a difference in society. You know, but the only way that we're going to really be able to do that is if we have a great attitude and we have great energy levels. We have high energy levels. So that takes some practice. A lot of us develop habits that aren't getting us where we need to be. So I want to give you two tips for attitude and energy today. Now there's a lot more, and I suggest and I encourage you guys to reach out to Mitch and I, whether it's on our YouTube channel, Motivated by the Mission, or the Facebook page, just comment below and say, hey, I'd like to learn more. We'll make sure you get the information. But two things that you can implement literally right this second that would make a difference in your attitude. Number one, when you first wake up, I mean first thing in the morning, right? You get your coffee or whatever that is, and then I want you to read or listen to something inspirational, motivational, or educational. Do that for a minimum of 15 minutes to start your day off. Control the spirit of your day, control your psyche. Do not put the news on first thing, right? The news, their job is to sensationalize all of the bad stuff that happened in the entire world, condense it, and then give it to you. Now, I'm not saying bury your head in the sand. You know, we want to be aware of current events. But that first thing that you're going to put into your consciousness in the morning is going to be something that's going to benefit your attitude. It's going to make you feel good, right? I'll leave that up to you. I have some suggestions, some things that I do. If you're interested, reach out. I'd be happy to talk about it. This is my passion. This is what I love teaching. So first thing in the morning, inspirational, motivational, educational, minimal 15 minutes. You have 15 minutes to dedicate towards your well-being. Okay? Finally, second thing, at the end of the night, last thing, right before you go to bed, if you have a partner, it's great to do that this with them, but a gratitude list. What are three things that you're grateful for? List them. I'm grateful for this, I'm grateful for this, I'm grateful for this. And then go to sleep. So you marinate in gratitude and you wake up to motivation, inspiration, or something that educates you, makes you better in your field or whatever you're interested in. Okay? So those two things, if you implement them right now, will get you where you want to be as far as attitude. Okay? Energy. Energy, the most simplest way to put, you know, I could talk about nutrition, I could talk about exercise, and yes, they, you know, they're mandatory, the research is out, but two things that aren't discussed enough. Number one, hydration. You know, the body is over 70% water. Make sure you're getting your minimum eight-ounce glasses. That's 64 ounces of water per day so that you're hydrated enough. A lot of times our energy levels are low because we're not getting the amount of water that we need to function at the level that we need to function at, right? So water and then rest. If you're getting 5 hours of sleep per night, and I realize a lot of my listeners may have young children and newborns who are preventing that, but you have to find time to get those naps in. If you're not getting the rest necessary for your body to recover and regain the energy that it has been exerting each and every day, it's gonna impede your energy levels, big time. You're not getting the rest and relaxation that you need, and your physical vitality is gonna pay the price. So hydration and rest, you know, 8 hours is great. Between 7 and 8 hours, if you're able to do that consistently, you know, it's worth it. It's worth turning the TV off an hour or two early so that we can be in this category. We can be the difference makers that all of us deserve to be and all of us strive to be. So hopefully you guys got something out of this message. As I said before, if you want more tips, if you want more information on how you can be the difference maker in your world, please reach out. That's what we're doing here at Motivated by the Mission. If you haven't yet, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Motivated by the Mission. Also like our Facebook page, give us a thumbs up, and until next time, have a great week.